We're going to stick with this idea of what is Hatha Yoga, just because this is our branch. This is our path. Ashtanga Yoga is a form of Hatha Yoga. My teacher, he said that Ashtanga, it's a method that is all-including. What he meant by that was that all of the kind of the best parts of Hatha Yoga are assembled into one method that you can do daily in 90 minutes when you do Ashtanga. So by practicing every day, whether you even know it or not, you're becoming skilled in the techniques of Hatha Yoga. But it's also helpful to know what those are, okay? And the Hatha Yoga Pradipika helps you to identify what are those techniques and then single them out better when you practice. And the four chapters give it to you nicely. So asana, pranayama, mudra, and samadhi. Okay, and so I'm encouraging you to think of your Ashtanga practice as made up of those four things. Many styles of yoga, they only emphasize the asana. And you can even practice Ashtanga in a way where it's more slanted towards the postures, towards like achieving binding in Marichyasana D, or being able to drop back to the floor. And we get these very kind of asana or physical goals and associate accomplishment or progress with the meeting those goals. Okay, and so part of the reason to even pick up the Hatha Yoga Pradipika is to what I call add layers, or to get deeper into what is this technology that is Hatha Yoga, and to represent the other three main categories more, which is pranayama, mudra, and samadhi. The layering that you're doing, partly you can see it as the image of the staircase. Okay, so that if you're using Hatha Yoga as a staircase to step up, to climb up to the high pinnacled Raja Yoga, then you could say that those four categories are main steps. So you go from asana to pranayama. You step up to pranayama. And then you step up from pranayama to mudra. And each layer adds complexity. And it's more subtle and a little bit more elusive, more challenging to get to. Okay, so that breathing is more challenging than using your physical body to make an asana. And then it's more challenging to see your breathing in terms of pranic movements in the body. And then it's more challenging to find those energetic seals at the ends of the breath and the idea of sealing in your energy, your senses, your attention is leading you towards the fourth category, which is samadhi. Hatha yoga is simply Raja yoga, right? So that all those things that you're doing are leading you to the experience that you want to have. And you just have to go deeper into the asana, deeper into the breathing, deeper into the bandhas and mudras that you're working on daily. And slowly, 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 you come around to this kind of more profound, more full expression of the technology.